Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is best known for her role as the voice of Pam on the hit Emmy Award-winning animated adult series Archer.
Please welcome down to the circle the very talented Amber Nash.
I'm so excited.
Hi, Amber.
How are you?
Oh my gosh, you're so good.
So cute.
Thank you.
Have a seat. Purple Thank marks you. Your spot. Yes. So, Amber.
Yes.
The word is you're from Georgia.
I am.
Now, how was that growing up in Georgia? And how did you pursue your acting career? Because, you know, it wasn't here before.
Yeah. And, you know, when I went to school, I did not study acting. I studied psychology because I didn't think being an actor was a viable career choice.
Well, like, psychology, you got to trick people. You can use that degree every day.
It works talking to actors, let me tell you. Having a psychology degree
helps.
That's right.
Right. And then I always thought, you know, if I'm going to be an actor, I have to move to L.A., I have to move to New York,
right.
And I didn't have to leave. I kept working here, and now look at the industry. It's
exactly.
insane.
It's great in Georgia right now.
Yeah, it's really amazing.
So how did you know that voices was going to be your focus? Like, when did you know, okay, I'm about to turn up in this area?
Yeah, it was never my plan. I started out doing theater, mm-hmm. Improv theater, and all you have is your body. You don't have costumes. You don't have sets.
Yeah.
And so I learned to use my voice to create characters. And then when I got asked to do voice work, I kind of had that bank of voices and characters.
Right.
And that's kind of how it all started.
Cool. Nice.
Yeah.
Now, you play Pam Poovey.
Yes.
On the adult show called Archer.
Mm-hmm.
Now, tell us a little bit about this character. And because I read some things about it. So tell me about her.
She is bad news.
Well, I won't say that, but she's
Pam
a
turn
up. She's
she
a good time.
Yeah. So she started out as the director of HR at this kind of like spy agency,
mm-hmm.
and the show's changed every season. Now we kind of reboot and things are a little bit different,
mm-hmm.
and she has gotten into all kinds of trouble. She can fight, she can drift car race.
Okay,
she
scrapper?
Can, yeah, she can yeah. tag, she is just all over the place, she can do anything.
Now, is this character inspired by anyone?
I don't think so. I think in the beginning they expected her to kind of be like a little bit of a punching bag. Like
okay.
they just needed a butt of the jokes, and she was kind of that character. And then she just kind of started to become awesomer and awesomer, and they were like, mm-hmm. oh, wait a minute. This girl knows what she's doing, so watch out.
They underestimated the Georgia girl
that
in you.
Right.
Right.
Now, Pam gets her curse on.
Oh, yeah.
She turns up in this series.
Yeah.
And she battles drug addiction
mm-hmm.
and abuse.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that when you signed on that this character was going to entail that? Oh,
no, wow. I don't think anybody did. Like, she
wow.
just kind of just shot out in all different directions and became a bunch of different things.
Yeah.
And when she was addicted to cocaine for an entire season.
Yes.
And it was crazy.
As a cartoon.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we were really
Same.
Dealing with
right.
some stuff. And then the next season, we just never talked about it again.
Oh, so, wow.
Yeah.
That's how it goes
down. That's the great
down.
Thing about cartoons, right?
Things, right?
Right.
Like, it was here and then it's over.
Yeah.
Right. So you often go to conventions where
yes.
you're dressed up as Pam Poovey.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, what has been one of your most unique or memorable encounter with fans?
Oh, it's incredible. The craziest thing is people will come up to me and show me, like, this one woman had an entire thigh tattoo of Pam. And so
wow.
to see that on somebody's body, and I see lots of tattoos, and cosplayers, people dressed up like
right.
Pam. There's a lot of men that like to dress up like Pam, too, which is
well,
one of my
we
favorites.
We are in that time and day, you know, day and age, right.
Yeah. Man Pam is my favorite.
Well, Pam
yeah.
has, she had a little masculinity to her,
oh,
so
yeah.
I mean, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Pam has her own Twitter account.
She does.
Now, what is it like having to be this character, and she's her own person? She's already become a whole other person.
Yeah, well, when they asked me to write for Pam's Twitter feed, I was
mm-hmm.
like, I don't know if I can do this.
Right.
And so they asked me to, like, send in 30, like, a month worth of mm-hmm. tweets, and
Hilarious.
I sent them in, and they were like, these are entirely too yeah. dirty. And I was like, oh,
whoops. Well, don't ask me
then. Totally.
As an actress, what is your preparation for her voice? Like, what goes into her character you?
When I first created the character, they just showed me a picture of her head, and the voice that came out is the voice that I use when I'm talking, like, stories about my mom. Like,
mm-hmm.
oh, are you going to wear that out?
Right.
So that was just kind of the voice that came out.
That's
and
all
I was
my
like,
mother's
voice. Right,
clearly.
Right, right.
That's her. It just came right out of me. Yeah.
Now, you work with the funny Aisha Tyler.
Oh, my gosh. She's amazing.
What is it like working with Aisha, and how do you guys inspire each other when you're working on set?
She is such an empowering person. Like, the
yes.
first time I met her, like, she's such a celebrity, and I was just this actress from Georgia. Like, I didn't know anybody. And we were at San Diego Comic-Con, and we were waiting for, like, a panel to start.
Mm-hmm.
And this door opens, and Aisha walks in, and she's like 7 feet tall, and she's wearing
wow.
a white suit, and it was like the angels were singing.
Yes,
because she's so gorgeous. Right. I'm just like, oh my, oh, I'm so intimidated. But we've become friends, and I'm so, I did a film of hers that she just directed last year, and she's just an incredible woman. I'm so proud to be in her life.
Now, we know that you have your own sister circle, and we can't let you leave our sister circle without telling us who's in yours. So tell us a little bit of who is in your sister circle.
Oh, and you know, it took me a while to kind of realize I needed to be around women. I was one of those, like, one of the boys for a long time. And then when I got older, I was like, oh, like, women are way more fun to hang out with.
Very fun. Right? I love somebody.
Turn up, ladies.
And so I'm lucky that I still live in the same city with my actual sister, Michelle, and my niece, Jasmine, who's just the best, and my friend, Megan, and Whitney, who both work with me at the theater in Atlanta that
How
I work
cool.
at.
How cool. Now, what theater is that? Because I'm a stand-up also.
It's Dad's Garage Theater. We do improv comedy every weekend.
Well,
every
thank you so much, Amber, for coming down to the Circle, and we loved hanging with you here. Archer Season 9 premieres Wednesday, April 25th on FXX.